Hello children, I hope you all are doing well. I'm your maths teacher Shweta Bajaj. Heyo, I'm back again with chapter 2, whole numbers. But before starting, please like and subscribe my channel so that you get the video notifications on time. And please don't forget to write your name, class and section in the comment section to mark yourself as present. Now students, in the previous video, we started with our exercise 2C. Now today again we are going to continue with our exercise 2C. So let's start. Now firstly I have taken is question number 9. This question says that find the largest 5 digit number that is exactly divisible by 567. Now students, you already know that largest 5 digit number is 99,999. Now what we will do, we will divide this number by 567. Now divide it firstly, 567 ones are 567. Subtract them, 9 minus 7 will give me 2, 9 minus 6 will give me 3, 9 minus 5 will give me 4. And this 9 will be carried down. Now, next number, what next number you can take here? You can take 7. Because 567 sevens are 3969. Now, subtract them. 9 minus 9 will give me 0. Now, 6 cannot be subtracted from 2. So, we will carry and on carrying it will become 12. And this number will become 2. 12 minus 6 will give me 6. Now, this 9 cannot be subtracted from 2. So, we will carry. On carrying, it will become 12 and it will become 3. Now, 12 minus 9 is equals to 3 and 3 minus 3 is 0. Right. Now, this 9 will be carried. Okay. Now, what next number you can take here? The next number you can take is 6. 5, 6, 7, 6 are 3,400. Now subtract them. 9 minus 2 will give me 7. 0 minus 0 will give me 0. 6 minus 4 will give me 2. And 3 minus 3 will give me 0. So this 176 is the quotient and 207 is the remainder. Now on dividing 99,999 by 567, we get a remainder. We get a remainder 207. Now, if we subtract this remainder 207 from 99,999, we get 99,999 minus 207. On subtracting, what you will get? 9 minus 7, 2. 9 minus 0, 9. 9 minus 2, 7. Then 9 and 9, right? 99,792, which is exactly divisible by 567. If you want, you can check whether this number 99,792 is divisible by 567 or not. So hopefully question number 9 is clear to you. Now, next I have taken is question number 10. It says that find the smallest 4 digit number that is exactly divisible by 24. So, as we know that smallest 4 digit number is 1000. Now, what we will do? We will divide this number by 24 firstly. On dividing, what you will get? 24 fours are 96. 100 minus 96 will give us 4. The 0 will be carried. Now 24 ones are 24. And on subtracting, what you will get? 16 as your remainder. Okay. So 16 is the remainder and 41 is the quotient here. Now on dividing 1000 by 24, we get our remainder as 16. But we cannot subtract it from 1000 because we want to find out the smallest 4-digit number. And if I will subtract this from 1000, I will get a 3-digit number. Okay, so we can add a number to 1000 to make it divisible by 24. And how to find out that number? This 16 will be subtracted from 24. So 24 minus 16 will give me 8. Hence, 1000 plus 8 is equals to 1008 is divisible by 24. If you want, you can check by dividing 1008 by 24 whether it is completely divisible or not. So, hopefully, question number 10 is clear to you. Now, next I have taken is question number 8. It says that find the smallest number that must be added to 8249 so that when it is divided by 313, we get no remainder. So firstly, we will divide this 8249 by 313. So 313 twos are 626. Subtract them. 6 cannot be subtracted from 4. So we will carry, it will become 14 and it will become 1. 14 minus 6 will give us 8. Now 2 cannot be subtracted from 1. So we will carry and it will become 11 and this number will become 7. 11 minus 2 will give us 9. 7 minus 6 will give us 1. Now 198 we will get on subtracting and this 9 will be carried down. Okay, now 313, 6 are 1878. On subtracting, what you will get? 9 minus 8 is equals to 1, 8 minus 7 is equals to 1, 9 minus 8 is equals to 1. Therefore, this 26 is our quotient and 111 is our remainder. So, what we will do now? We want to find out the smallest number that must be added. So, that number will be given by on subtracting 111 from 313. On subtracting, what you will get? 3 minus 1, 2. 1 minus 1. 0. 3 minus 1, 2. You will get 202. Therefore, 202 is the smallest number that must be added to what? 8249 in order to get the remainder as 0. Remainder as 0. So, hopefully, question number 8 is also clear to you. Now, next I have taken is question number 13. It says that find the product using suitable properties. And the first part is 635 into 105. Now students, this 105 can be written as 100 plus 5. Further, by distributive property of multiplication over addition, this 635 will be multiplied by 100 plus. Again, 635 will be multiplied by 5. In the bracket, mention the property used, distributive property. Now, 635 into 100 will give us 635 will give us 3175. And on adding, what we will have? We will have 66,675 as our answer. So, hopefully, part first is clear to you. Now, next I have taken is third part of question number 13. In third part, 869 into 87 is given to us. Now, there are two methods for doing this part. In first method, what we can take? We can take this 87 as 80 plus 7. And in the second method, we can write this 87 as 90 minus 3. Now, here, distributive property of multiplication over addition is used. So, it says that 869 will be multiplied by 80 firstly. Then, this middle sign plus will come. And then, 869 will be multiplied by 7. Now, on multiplying 869 with 80, what we will get? What we will get? We will get 69,520. And on multiplying 869 with 7, what we will get? We will get 6,083. On adding, what you will get? You will get 75,603 as your answer. Now, see your second method. Here, which property is used? Distributive property of multiplication over subtraction is used. And according to that property, 869 will be multiplied by 90 firstly, minus 869 will be multiplied by 3. Now, on multiplying 869 by 90, what you will get? You will get 78,210 minus, on multiplying 869 with 3, what you will get? You will get 2,607. Now, finally, on subtracting them, what you will get? You will get 75,603 as your answer. Students, you can use any of these two methods for solving your question. So, hopefully, question number 13 is clear to you, and you will be able to solve the remaining parts of this question. So, after understanding today's work, I hope you will be able to do the home task attached in the PDF form in description. For any doubts and queries, you can leave your message in comment section. I hope you like the video. Thank you.